Hello everyone, welcome to the next challenge. Let's solve a hard difficulty problem in this video. Link to this challenge is given in the description below. So in this challenge, we have to solve maximum circular subarray sum problem, which means that given an array of n integers arranged in a circular fashion, your task is to find the maximum contiguous subarray sum. Let's solve it in Jupyter Notebook. Now, to approach this particular problem, we need to know what is Cadan's algorithm. Let us try to understand Cadan's algorithm with respect to this particular array. This particular array is already provided to us in Geeks for Geeks. So I've taken the same array. Now let's try to understand what Cadan's algorithm is. Now, we will have this array. Now let's create two sections here. One we will say overall best, and I will say current best. Okay. Now, you can probably say current best sum or overall best sum. Now, we will iterate over these elements in the array one by one. So our first element is 8. Okay. Now let's look at 8. So currently it's our first element. So sum is 8. Sum is 8. And number of elements are the elements that I consider to calculate the sum is 8. And since this is the current best sum, so that we will put, since this is the first element, so that will go in my overall best sum as well. Now, next element is minus 8. Now, minus 8 will say that, okay, I am a negative number. So my negative number, the negative number will compare it, or this particular item will basically compare with the previous sum that the array has received. So currently my previous sum is 8, and minus 8 will say, okay, I am less than the previous sum. So it is better to get connected with the previous sum. And now 8 will be added to 8 and it will become 0 here. And this will become 8, minus 8. But now, is this 0 greater than this particular 8? No. So our overall best sum remains this. Let's move on to the next element, 9. 9 will say that, okay, previous sum is 0. And I myself am 9. All right. So 9 is greater than the previous sum. All right. So 9 will start its own list here. So 9 will be equal to 9 will be the new sum, and this will be discarded completely. All this which is done is discarded. Now 9 is definitely better than the overall best sum. So this 9 will be added in this particular list. Now let's move on to the next element, minus 9. Now minus 9 here will say that I am less than the previous sum, which is 9 here. So definitely now minus 9 will come. This will be 0. This will be added. Minus 9 will be added to the previous one. So this will become 0. And this will be like minus 9, minus 9. Now this 0 is again not best than the overall sum. So this is our best sum as of now. Now moving on to value 10. Now for 10, 10 will say that I am greater than the previous sum, which is currently 0. So I will start my own list. So 10 will be 10. And it will say, yes, that I am more than the overall best sum as of now. So 10 will be added here with 10 in the list. Next will be minus 11. Now minus 11 is less than 10. So minus 11 will be added to 10 and the sum will become minus 1, and this will be 10, minus 11. But is this better than the overall sum? No. So this remains the overall sum, best overall sum. Now coming to 12. Now here, what will happen that minus, 1 will be added to 12. Minus 1 will be added to 12. Now, when minus 1 is added to, this 12 will say that I am the, I am greater than the previous sum. I am greater than the previous sum. So what will happen? This minus 1 will not be considered. This whole thing will be discarded. Like over here, 10 had to discard the previous one. Now here, same thing will happen. Since 12 is greater than the minus 1, till this 12 will form a new list. So this 12 will be like 12, this one, and this 12 will form. This 12 will become the overall best sum. Now this is Kadane's algorithm. Now this we can perform. This is this approach that we did right now is not considering that the array is a circular array. Now let's try to consider what we will do in a circular array. So if this question was that you have to find out the maximum sum in a subarray from an array, like maximum sum subarray, this would have been your output. Because we are not considering here a circular subarray, all right? So this 12 would have been the maximum value here because that is the maximum sum subarray, not considering that it is circular. Now, let us try to understand how we can use Kadane's algorithm to find a circular maximum circular sum subarray. Let us see that. Let's understand several cases here. First case here is like you have this particular array, all right? Now, I said that probably the first case is that your subarray lies in between the array, like probably this one, maybe, for example, okay? It is not doing any wraparounds. My second case could be that this is my entire array and probably that this is my subarray, considering that it is a circular array. What does a circular array mean? That it will assume that after 12, 8 is coming. Meaning, I'm not considering that 12 is the end of my array. I'm creating a circular array. So 12 is connected with 8 and so on. So here, you can consider this like this, like this one will be connected with like 8 and minus 8 and 9 and minus 9, 10, minus 11 and 12. Okay. So here you have this particular, and same list I have written again. So you can say that this is my maximum subarray, for example. Okay. So you will notice that there are two elements at the end and probably three elements at the start. Also, the size has to be fixed. Like this is the maximum you can go. Okay. So that will be taken care of the maximum length of the array. But here, if you see that I have two elements here and I have three elements on the left hand side. So that means that we are trying to consider a circular subarray and that the arrays, all the elements are not present like, contiguously within the range, but they are in a circular format, as in some elements are on the right hand side and some elements are on the left hand side. Okay. Now, how we will solve that problem? We will have to understand one concept here, which means that let's say that I have an array. Okay. Let's say I have an array. Now, if I have this particular array and I have, let's say this is the boundary where I have, let's say some elements here. I have some elements here. Now, if this, the total of this and this is maximum, which means that this particular part will be minimum because the total of this and this will give you the sum of all the elements of your array. This is basic math. So you can say that let's say this is S1 and let's say this is S2. So S1 and S2 will give you the sum of your array. All right. So we will solve this. So what we will do is in our program, we will try to find out the maximum sum. We will find out the total sum. We will find out maximum sum. We will find out minimum sum. And in between, we will keep finding out current minimum and current maximum. We will also find these two. Okay. So we have to find many things here. We have to find the total sum of the array. We have to find the maximum sum of the array. We have to find the minimum sum of the array. And we have to find current minimum, current maximum, which means currently at that particular index, what is the minimum and what is the maximum? When I told you this particular example, let's say when we were talking about the second index. So when I'm saying current minimum or current maximum, it means at that particular index, what is the minimum and what is the maximum? Okay. And once we find out that, we can say that the maximum out of these two is the output. All right. So if this is maximum out of maximum sum and minimum sum, which means that this is the maximum circular sum subarray. If this is maximum, then this is supposed to be the output of the maximum circular subarray, which means that you had a circular array. Maybe your elements were in such a way that some elements were at the end and some elements were in the beginning. Okay. Now, we have another case here. Let's say we have only one element in the array. So that is the output. We don't have to do anything with that. That will only be your output. We have one final case that we have to consider here, that what if all my elements are negative? Suppose all my elements are negative. So what will be your outcome? Your outcome will be the largest element, which will be -1. Okay. We will see this case as well. All right. So how we will produce this particular case? Let's say your sum will be some value. Sum will be -1, -3, which will be -4, then -14, -16, -19 will be my sum. Okay, -19 will be my sum. So -19 is my sum here, which is doing what? If that is equal to my minimum value, it means that I have to return the maximum value so far. Okay, because when I'm trying to compute this, I will get my sum also -19 and I will get my minimum also -19. So when this is the case, it means that return the maximum value, maximum so far, which will be maximum sum. So this will be my output if this is the case. Okay, now let's try to do this programmatically. Now, let me just remove this. So let's try to code this. I will say that now let's do our first scenario, which means if my array contains only one element. So if n is equal to one, here n is the size of my array and a is the array here. Okay, a is the array here. So if n is equal to 1, I will return a of 0. Simple. Now, next case, I will initialize my sum. Sum is equal to 0. Now, I will say that let me loop over my elements. For i in range, I will say n. I will have to find out the sum of the elements. I told you we have to find a couple of things here. We have to find the sum. We have to find minimum sum. We have to find maximum sum. And we have to find a current minimum and current maximum. We have to find this. So I hope we have understood what exactly is the difference between current minimum and minimum. So you can say current minimum is at that particular index. So if there are certain elements at that particular index, what is the minimum? And max minimum sum is the global minimum. So far, what is the minimum? And same way concept goes for maximum as well. So now we are finding out our first parameter here, which is sum. So I will say that sum plus equal to a of i. Okay. Now let me find out current max, or let's say let me initialize all these four parameters remaining with the first parameter. So let me just say that current maximum is equal to A of zero, current minimum is equal to A of zero, max sum is equal to A of zero, and min sum will be equal to A of zero. I have just initialized with the very first value. Now what am I supposed to do? I will say for I in range 1 comma n. Okay. Now current maximums, since I have already initialized, the first element I have already considered here, so I will start with the next element. Now I will check current maximum. Okay, current maximum, I have to find maximum of, current maximum plus A of I, either that is maximum or A of I. So what have I basically done here? I'm trying to say that let me consider this element. So here when I'm running this particular loop, my element is minus 8. So what it is trying to do, it is trying to say that now current max is A of 0, which means current max is equal to 8. Okay, now minus 8. So minus 8 plus 8. Okay, minus 8 plus 8 is what? So minus 8 plus 8 is 0. Okay, minus 8 plus 8 is 0. So it will check whether this 0 is greater than. So what is the maximum of 0 and minus 8? So this is minus 8 and this sum is basically 0 here. So who is the maximum? 0 is the maximum. So my current maximum here is at this position. Okay, so what is the maximum? Maximum will be 0. So my current maximum will become 0 in this case. Now let's move on to the next statement, which means, so let me just erase this off. Yeah. Now let us find current minimum. What will be current minimum? Nothing, but maximum will be replaced by minimum. And I will say current minimum plus A of I and out of these two. So basically out of A of I and current minimum plus A of I, whichever is the minimum will be stored in current minimum. Now next is maximum sum. So max sum is the global maximum, which means that I can simply say that it is the maximum of max, whatever max sum stores as of now, and what is current maximum. Same way, I will put it for minimum sum as well. So I'll copy this and I'll paste it here, which means this is going to be min sum, and this is going to be min of min sum and current minimum. Okay. Now, this we have done the, what I explained you in the previous scenario, that we are trying to find out the minimum, current minimum and the global minimum and current maximum with global maximum. Okay. Now we have to perform one case that we discussed here. What if we have all elements as negative elements? So we will just compare it with, we will simply compare if minimum sum is equal to my sum. So do what? Return max sum. Okay. Otherwise, return what? Otherwise, just return max of max sum, or I told you that we have this mathematical formula here. If max sum is my maximum, meaning your array found out some elements which were not in a circular fashion, meaning all elements were inside my array. Second case was that I have some elements where some elements are here, some elements are here. So which means it is taking some elements from the right hand side, some elements from the rest left hand side. So it has not found elements in between. It has found some elements, like this is a subarray. So in this case, we have to find the minimum and we will subtract it from the total. We will subtract it from the total and we will find out this particular maximum sum. So we discussed that maximum sum plus minimum sum is equal to sum. Okay, so we will apply this formula here. So I will simply put it here and say that, and whichever is the maximum out of this, whichever is the maximum out of this, either this or this, okay? Basically from here, whichever is the maximum. So if let's say it has found some maximum here in between, or it has found some maximum here, a maximum out of those two will ultimately be your output. So I will simply say that either maximum sum or sum minus minimum sum. And that is your output. So this will be your output. Now what we are going to do, we will simply copy this code and we will paste it in our console. On, you will find this problem on multiple flat platforms. You will probably find it on LeetCode as well. So just find this problem and you have to paste the same. You might have to just do some changes with respect to the function definition and how it is accepting inputs. Otherwise, the whole concept will be same here. And you will simply submit this one and you will find that it's the correct answer. Yes, so it's a correct answer. So yes, so we are done solving this problem. If you have any queries, please get back to me in the form of comments, or you will find my social media links on the banner. So see you in the next challenge. That's all for this one. Keep practicing.